Yo, what's up guys, back again with me Mato. Today video I will make a photo manipulation for t-shirt design. This time I don't want to make something grungy like my previous designs, but I came along with more clean and simple without threshold or any kind of like that. I will also share with you guys some Photoshop tips and tricks throughout the video. So without further ado, let's go. Alright, as you can see, I prepared the images that I will use in my design composition. I tried to make something cool with that, and of course you will see it at the moment. I get a few stock assets close enough to sketch from Envato Elements or unsplash.com. I put that link in the description below. I started by cropping this hand image using a pen tools. There are no specific tools to any cropping process. You're free to use any kind of cropping tool you like, by the way. And yeah, I won't bore you with the cropping part guys, so we'll just speed that part up and talk to you guys in a bit. Alright, so now I'm going to drop these images to working file, and I do assembling and make initial composition right now. I will share some trick to you guys for make all these images look unified together, because we will be playing with combining these images. Sometimes we have to cut out some part of these images to make them look more unified with each other. Usually I removing some parts using a eraser tool. It's so simple actually, but yeah, I'm not sure if I'm good to explain it, but you'll see me start it on the screen. So yeah, make sure you all layer on set to smart object, then add a mask layer, click eraser tool, and we can go to removing part that we don't want it. Make sure your background foreground color set in black and white. You can copy my setting if you want it. Do the same steps for all images when you do adjustments. Of course, there will be a lot of composition work done later on, so yeah, let's see. After all the images have been assembled and become one composition, now I'm going to merge it by converting to smart object so that it separates into three layers only, and name it each layer so I can get confused with all these things. Now I decide to change the snake color to black and white by use saturation and drop down the saturation value as much as I can. And then play a little bit with the level for increase the contrast. So now I'm keeping to balancing the color tone with more vintage hue, as like as rose color tone by hue saturation. And drop down a saturation value a bit to catch up the color tone of the rose image. And you can go to filter and pick add noise to increase the sharpness to all your images. Alright guys, so now I decide to add more color. We change the nails color to the red. That are same vibes color with the rose color, and I hope it will be pop in the composition already. So click the hand layer, click icon below, and pick hue saturation. Then clipping mask it. Now click colorize, and I play with slider to find the most appropriate color. Now hit layer mask and press Command I to invert the layer mask. Make sure your background color set to black and white. Now pick eraser tool. I choose soft round brush to bring out a blurry edges when I painting it, and spread it all into your nails area. You can come back to adjust the color again by click Use Saturation layer and play with slider again. Next up is I want to bring all these things more lively by adding shadows, especially on the part of the image which is cropped separately. Yeah, as you know, I'm never skip this process because I don't know, I really love and obsessed to adding small details like that. So yeah, hit icon below and choose brightness and contrast. Then clipping mask it. Now play with slider to make it more darker. Invert the mask layer back, press Command I. Come back again to eraser tool. Set flow value around 40%. And pick soft round brush and set your brush size. And we're good to go. This will make the image more dimensional and live unified together. And I'm painting it all smoothly using a brush tool with soft round brush. Alright guys, now I prepared my layer before adding the highlights. I grouped all my layers into a folder and give it a name. So my layer panel more cleanly from any kind of layer that can be confusing me. Next up is I put a solid color adjustments on the top of my folder. Let's start with white color. Clipping mask it into a folder. I change the blend mode to soft light. Click layer mask and press Command I to invert. Make sure again if your background color exactly black and white. Now click eraser tool again and set all the brush setting at the same as before. You can gently and smoothly painting it all just only on the edges of your image. By the way, if you really to deep dive know about this process, I've uploaded a full tutorial of how I create a dramatic highlight without any plugin in it. You can check it out in the pop-up on the top right corner. And yeah, I won't bore you with this part, guys, so we'll just speed it up and talk to you in a bit. Stay tuned. Alright guys, now you can see before and after the result of my highlights. It can drive my design so much better and really well. So yeah, let's move on to another part. Now I'm gonna add more detail by adding some texture over it. As you know, I really love to do these things so much, just to kind of add more character to it and have an aesthetic impression. I am at my halftone texture and do some of transformation or readjust the texture until look really good on the composition. By the way, you can download this texture on my store, link in the description below. So I am also just going to keep on testing out this blending mode. This is the things, guys, you should always experiment when you're designing. Sometimes the result really shocks you. Now I wanted to create a little missing chunk effect over there, which give the design kind of chip away look, and I think it's gonna be a really cool idea. So I combine my halftone texture with my crack overlay. Clipping masses again. Change a blend mode to lighten for removing the background and do some adjustment a bit. Alright, now I invert my crack texture by command I and change the blend mode to color burn, so it's quickly turn my texture to the black. Alright, so yeah, as you can see, my rough missing chunk effect are completely done. Now let's make something cool again by adding some highlight along the missing chunk edges with the same process on the previous part. But for now, I'm gonna speed it up a little bit. Stay tuned, guys. Alright guys, I got perfect adjustments to the design and honestly the result is really shocks me. I'm really happy with it. Now let's add some off text in it and go to apply the design to a short mockup and show you the final results. Let's go. Alright guys, so that it's all for today. I hope you learned something new from this video. I'll be uploading another video later this week, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. Follow me on Instagram for more behind the scenes. Thanks for watching my video. See you on the next one. Peace.